Greetings, comrade Mungu.
Scala,
the national spokesperson of Zimbabwe of youth advocates for reform and democracy,
yes.
Which is, of course, associated with a controversial policy in comrade Zimbabwe.
Yes.
Comrade, what is your position in regards to Dombo's denials of a master's degree?
Yes, I think before I became the spokesperson of YAD, I knew Dombo as a student at the University of Zimbabwe. He was a very bright student.
Uh-huh.
He was able to participate at the University of Zimbabwe. For you to be participating in public offices in the SRC,
easy.
You have to be to prove to be a competent student academically. Dombo
uh-huh.
managed to participate in second year.
Uh-huh.
Dombo throughout his term as the president,
easy.
Dombo was able to pass his courses. I always knew Dombo is a personal friend.
Uh-huh.
Dombo passed. And yet he has more than the qualification of 2.2, which is required for someone to be a master's student.
Yeah.
So denying Dombo the capacity to be a master's student is tantamount to denying a citizen of Zimbabwe the right to education, which is confined in the constitution. And it goes so much as to say that Levi Nyagura has been solely responsible for the demise of the right to education, which is protected by the constitution of this country. So Levi Nyagura is against the president of this country. He's against his appointee. Let us remember that Levi Nyagura was not elected into being the vice chancellor of this institution. He was appointed by the president, who is the chancellor. So he's against his chancellor. He's not respecting the center of power that he agrees to respect.
So, Comrade Mungu, if you asked to advise Nyagura right now, what would you say to
you? No, Nyagura has got to resign. I cannot advise a person who has been in office more than 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
Your mathematics degree, which you got as a PhD in 1998, it is not you cannot lead in the contemporary problems of this country. The problems of Zimbabwe, the problems of the globe have been moving at a very supernatural rate. You cannot lead 24 years or 14 years after you've become a PhD holder. Levi Nyagura is not fit to lead the University of Zimbabwe.
So
he does not understand the crisis of the University of Zimbabwe students.
Yeah, correct. So does this fit the fact that Nyagura is a cake?
Nyagura is ZANU-PF. He's G40, not ZANU-PF. Not ZANU-PF alone. He's G40 and he's part of the crew that is destroying the cabal, that is destroying the country, that is disrespecting the legitimacy and the legacy of the president of Zimbabwe.
So what's your advice to the nation?
The nation has got to vote against Mugabe, has got to vote against ZANU-PF, has got to remove people like Levi Nyagura. I'm happy the vice president of the MDCT, Comrade Nelson Chamisa, was clear that in a new Zimbabwe, Levi Nyagura would not be in charge of the university. Tontai Dombo is an academic astute.
Mm-hmm.
Tontai Dombo, the only thing that brought him to the one thing that brought him to the limelight of world politics is when he lifted the placard against President Mugabe, saying we have graduated,
mm-hmm.
but we don't have jobs. Can you make sure you provide jobs, not just a speech? Mm-hmm. And that was a very legitimate call that spoke to hundreds of thousands of students who graduate across all institutions.
So
he is a leader. And you cannot say you are not giving that leader a master's opportunity. He's astute. He's paying his own fees. The universities, the government is supposed to pay fees for Tontai Dombo. The government is not paying fees for Tontai Dombo. He's paying his own fees. The government has already shortchanged Dombo before they refused him.
Is it the same Tontai Dombo with the placard?
He's the same person. He's the president. I was the president of the USAID after Tontai Dombo.
What's unique about him?
Tontai Dombo has always been a revolutionary, he's always been standing up for the poor, he's always been about education. You know what I always told people, Mugabe, we cannot celebrate Mugabe for being a revolutionary in terms of making sure that people get education. Mugabe was the president of the country when he started to make educational reforms. We expected that from him. It was part of his job description. Tontai Dombo is not the president of this country. He's just an activist who's passionate about people getting jobs. In April, where he stays, in Mavoko, Tontai Dombo opened a school for students to get education, free education. He teaches those students for free. He's not employed and he's not using his time drinking beer. He's using his time to educate the people of Mavoko. He is better than Mugabe, and I think the only thing to do is to allow the world, the activists, the opposition and the world has got to take notice of this. Tontai Dombo must not be denied his right to get a master's degree.
He
is academically astute. He should get the master's degree. And they're going to push, even through the courts, through YAD, our organization, we're going to push through the courts for Dombo to get that master's. It is not legit, it's not justifiable for him to be denied that master's. He's the best student in his class. The records are, the records don't lie.
Well, thank you, former president.
Yes.
The former president of the University of Zimbabwe, for giving me this chance, this opportunity, the portal for us to unpack and take it into condemned challenges. What the students of the University of Zimbabwe are saying
yes,
about
thanks,
this
thanks.
Issue. I will talk to you.
Democratas.
Sure.
Sharp.
I will talk to you.
Yes.
Wow.
Download that is your
show. That was like.